Hey guys, welcome back. So today's video is going to be all about the bags that I've sold and the reasons why. So in a nutshell, I sold 15 designer handbags in the last year or so, and most of them I sold on my channel here in vlog sales. So I'm not gonna go into too much details about those 11 bags that I sold on videos here because you might have watched those videos already. And I also sold 4 Chanel bags through a consignment service, the Purse Affair here in Australia. So I'm going to focus more of my time talking about those sales. So simply put, the biggest reason why I sold so many handbags in the last year or so is to just streamline my collection, get rid of the redundant handbags, and just have a well-rounded but more of a capsule handbag collection that is versatile for my lifestyle without having too many numbers in my collection. And after having sold so many bags, now I feel like I'm not even gonna bother with a handbag unless I absolutely love everything about it. So there's gonna be a lot of eye candies and photos coming your way, so let's get started. So let me do a really quick rundown of all of the bags that I sold here on my YouTube channel in vlog sales. So for those of you who don't want to watch the whole vlog sale videos, you get a very quick overview of why I sold these items. So if you are considering these items, then maybe you will have a bit more idea whether you really want to add these items to your collection or not. I often find these videos more helpful than haul videos, unboxing videos, or videos that talk about how people love their items, because when people share things that don't work out for them, that can often give a better insight to someone who might be considering that. So hopefully you have more information going into one of these purchases. So the first bag I sold on my vlog sale is the Chloe Faye wallet on chain. It is a very tiny bag, very, very cute. I had it in the cognac color with the suede flap. I absolutely love the color of it, but it was just way too small for my lifestyle. I couldn't even fit my iPhone 7 Plus with a card holder and a key comfortably. So it started getting really frustrating and I sold it on. The next bag I sold was the Louis Vuitton Pochette Felicie in the Vernis leather color Amarant. It is the most beautiful color, but you know what? I just never really reached for it. And I think I purchased that bag when I did because I just wanted to have an item in the Vernis leather in that particular color, but I just never reached for that style, especially when I added my Saint Laurent Uptown pouch to my collection. This became my go-to evening bag. So the Pochette Felicie didn't really have a function in my collection because it wasn't really a day bag for me. And for the evening, I just had something that I always prefer to use. The third bag I sold was the Gucci Marmont mini camera bag in the beautiful cream white color with the antique brush gold hardware. I have gotten so much wear out of that bag, but when I added my beloved Chanel reissue in the exact same sort of color combination, I decided to let that one go because this white bag just replaced the color combination perfectly in my collection. The next bag I sold was the Louis Vuitton Speedy Bandolier in the size 25 in the monogram canvas. I bought that bag because I was influenced by Jerusha from Jerusha Couture. Although it is a very functional bag, at the point that I saw that bag, I had 3 monogram bags. That bag being a monogram, more casual day bag, I always found myself preferring my Neonoe. You guys know my love for this bag. So I found that bag a little bit redundant in my collection. And at this point, I also had the Pochette Matisse in my collection in that exact same color combination. So I decided to let that one go because out of the 3 monogram bags, the Speedy Bandolier to me was the least interesting looking bag. And also I just wasn't reaching for it as much as the other two. The next bag I sold was the Louis Vuitton Pochette Matisse in the Empreinte leather in the beautiful baby pink color. I unboxed that bag on my channel, but I've realized every time I buy that sort of a pink color, I never really use it. I did try to carry it, but all I did was get a few Instagram photos with it, but I found myself never really reaching for that color. So based on color, I just let that one go. So that was everything I sold in my first vlog sale here on YouTube. And then in my second vlog sale, I sold 6 further bags. So the next bag I sold really shocked you guys, and it is the Louis Vuitton Pochette Matisse in the monogram. When I first got that bag, I was so excited because it was such a difficult bag to obtain because there was a massive wait list for it. So I feel like I just bought into the hype of it, but soon I realized that style isn't really right for me, and it being such a popular bag that a lot of people want and they can't get their hands on, I thought, you know what, for someone who can incorporate this style of bag much better into their style, I should just let it become available for someone else. That was also a purely casual bag for me, and when I got my Loewe puzzle bag, I found myself reaching for this bag a lot more over that one when I am going for that brown tone neutral bag for a casual outfit. So when I noticed myself not using it for a while, I just decided to let it go, and no regrets. The next bag I sold was the Louis Vuitton Eva Clutch in the Demier Azure print. It was one of my very first Louis Vuitton bags that I ever bought, and I sold it for the same reason that when I'm going for a white bag, I started going for my Chanel reissue bag a lot more, and that was more of an evening bag for me as well, like a small clutch. So when I found myself not really reaching for it, I just decided to let it go. The next one that I sold on that vlog sale was the Louis Vuitton Neverfull in the size MM in the Demier Azure print. Now I already owned that exact same bag in the Demier Ebene print, and I got a lot of use out of that one, so I always thought I wanted to add a lighter color in that same bag, so I added the Demier Azure print. But possibly because of its lighter color, that bag just looked really bulky whenever I wore it. It just looked quite massive, and I didn't really like the aesthetics of that. It just looked fantastic on other people on Instagram and YouTube, but I didn't really enjoy carrying that one. The next one I sold was the Louis Vuitton Double Zip Pochette in the cream emprunt leather with the beautiful python accent. Oh my gosh, that bag was stunning, and I bought that in Milan last year when I was traveling in Italy. And to be really honest, I feel like I just got wrapped up in the whole hype of being in Milan in that store, and I just wanted to buy something. So I feel like I didn't really think that purchase through. And also that bag was a little bit too small for me as well. When I just put my bare minimum essentials in that bag, it just became a little bit too bulky. The next one I sold was the Valentino Glam Lock bag in the medium size in that beautiful nude color that they do. That is a stunning bag, but that was exclusively an evening bag for me, and I just don't have the need to have multiple evening bags in my collection. And whenever I reach for an evening bag, again, I was just reaching for my Uptown clutch all the time, so it just didn't make sense to keep that one as an exclusively evening bag. And the very last bag that I sold on my vlog sale was the Gucci Soho disco bag in the rose beige color. I sold that bag because it was an exclusively casual bag in my collection, and whenever I was going for a neutral sort of warm toned casual bag, again, I'd always reach for my Loewe puzzle bag, and I also got a little bit over the big GG logo at the front, so I didn't see the need to keep both this one and the Gucci Soho Disco because they both serve the same purpose in my collection. If you want to hear more about each bag, why I sold them, do check out those vlog sale videos because I do go into a bit more detail on why I've decided to let them go. Now onto the Chanel bags. You guys kind of know which Chanel bags that I sold. I sold 4 Chanel bags, 3 of them through the Purse Affair, and one of them I sold to one of you guys. Hope you are enjoying that bag, babe. Anyway, let me get started with the first Chanel bag that I sold, and that is the Chanel Jumbo Classic Flap in the black caviar leather with the gold hardware. It was the very first Chanel bag I ever bought, and I absolutely adored that bag for a really, really long time. The main reason I sold that bag was because it didn't really fit any purpose in my collection anymore now that my bag collection has evolved. I had other bags that fit each purpose in my life much better than that Chanel Jumbo. So for example, if I am looking for a black bag to use as a day bag, I'd go for something a little bit more casual that fits a little bit more, such as my Givenchy Antigone. And also it is a bit more subtle to use as a day bag without all the chains and things. So during the day, I found myself reaching for something simple and bigger like this. And if I was going for a more dressy bag, that Jumbo was a little bit large in size to use as an evening bag or whenever I'm a little bit more dressed up. And it just didn't look as elegant as having something a little bit smaller for those more dressed up looks. The other thing, I'm not a very tall person. I am only 164 centimeters tall, which is 5'4". So that bag often looked a little bit too bulky on me anyway. And the last reason for selling that bag is because I do have my Coco handle in the size small in my collection, which I actually really prefer over the Jumbo for a bag this size. They're pretty comparable in size, and I think for a bag this size from Chanel, the Coco handle looks a lot better. I feel like the classic flaps, unless you're a very tall lady, the medium or smaller sizes look better in that sort of dressy aesthetic. And the chain on the Jumbo is a lot chunkier than the chain on the medium or small or smaller sizes. So if you compare the chain on the Jumbo and the medium, you can see an obvious difference in the width of the chain. So the chain was becoming really heavy, and it just looked a little bit too fleshy for my liking. So although it was a really difficult decision to let it go in the end, I made that call, especially now that my collection has grown a lot since buying that Jumbo. I have other bags in my collection that can serve my life's needs a lot better. And you guys know that I sold two mini flaps. So one of them was the rectangular mini in that beautiful berry color with the light gold hardware in the lambskin. And the other one was the square mini in the black caviar leather with silver hardware with the chevron quilting. Common reason I sold both of them was because I had three Chanel mini flaps in my collection. And like I've mentioned time and time again this year in different videos, I am not really loving the tiny mini bags anymore because I find it a bit annoying to have to downsize so much. So I'm preferring the smaller size bags now, but not so much the mini. So at the beginning of this year, when I really decided to curate my collection and downsize a little bit more, I decided to only keep one Chanel Classic Mini in my collection, and I've decided the best one to keep in my collection would be this one that I still have in my collection. Now, those two bags were sold for different reasons. So I sold the rectangular mini in the berry color because I ended up scoring a Kelly bag in the size 25, as you guys know, at the beginning of this year. And all the outfits that I used to pair with the Chanel mini flap, although the colors are slightly different between this one and the mini flap that I sold, I could really tie all my looks with this bag now. And being a small size rather than being a mini bag, I found it a lot more user friendly and I didn't get so annoyed having to downsize so much. So I decided there's no point having two pop of color bags in a similar color family that I'm going to use for similar sorts of outfits anyways. And it went to one of my beautiful subscribers. So if you're watching, babe, I hope you are enjoying that one. I do absolutely think it is the most beautiful bag. And then the square mini in the chevron quilting in the black caviar leather with the silver hardware. I sold that one because I didn't want to keep two Chanel minis in the black color in the exact same size, but I did want to have both hardware options. So what I've ultimately decided on doing was to keep the light gold hardware one because it is a little bit more versatile. It dresses up a little bit better, whereas the one with the silver hardware with the caviar leather and the chevron quilting, that has a more casual look. So I thought if I keep this one here, this can be versatile enough, and the champagne gold hardware is really versatile too because you can match it with silver toned or gold toned jewelry. And also, instead of having two black mini bags in the exact same style, I thought I can add a bit of variety by adding something slightly different to my collection to replace that chevron mini with. So I ended up purchasing the YSL Mini Lu camera bag, which I absolutely love. Oh, I forgot. I also sold the same Mini Lu camera bag exactly like this, but with the gold hardware because of this decision. And I do talk a lot about that decision in the video where I unboxed this YSL bag. So that is the reason why I sold that mini Chanel flap. And because I was using that particular Chanel mini bag for more casual outfits, I thought something like this from YSL, which has a much lower price point, this is pretty much one third of the cost of the Chanel mini, I thought for that price point, this YSL bag serves a much better function in a casual outfit. So I just thought from the cost effective point of view, this is a much better choice and also adds a lot more variety to my collection. And then the bag that I've been getting a lot of questions about since I did my bag collection video is the Chanel boy flap in the dark gray color from the 2017 Cuba collection with the Ruthenium hardware in the lambskin in the old medium size. That is the most recent bag I sold. I just haven't been using that bag. It was sitting very pretty in my closet. I loved looking at it. I love the edginess of it. Chanel being a more classic fashion house, I just love the fact that that bag looked a little bit more edgy, and I just wanted to have a boy flap in my collection. And it was really coming from the collector in me just wanting to hold on to it with no practical reason of holding on to it. So earlier this year, I decided, okay, I have really not been using this boy bag. I don't know why, but I'm gonna really try and use it and incorporate it into my outfits. So I made a really conscious effort to carry that bag out more. And I realized the two biggest reasons why I wasn't using that bag. So the first reason is that chain is a little bit annoying. So with the boy flap, the chain is quite chunky. It's quite masculine. And because it is fed through two metal loops and there's no interwoven leather bits to the chain just keeps rotating around, moving around, and that was just driving me crazy. And it was a very clunky, loud bag as well. And the other thing that I realized really annoyed me was the flap. The flap is so big and heavy. So if you have a look at the other flap bags, the flap doesn't come all the way down, but it only comes down to about 2/3 of the height of the bag. But with the Boy flap, it came all the way down and the flap is very heavy. So whenever I went to open the flap of the bag to get into the bag, it was really heavy to hold onto the flap, get into the bag, grab my things or put things back and then close it. That flap just kept falling on me, and every time it fell on my hand and hit my hand, it was just really annoying. So all in all, for me, it wasn't a very user-friendly bag. I still think it is such a pretty bag, especially in that color. I absolutely love that color, so I do want to add back another gray bag in my collection sometime. But yeah, the chain and the flap, they were just really not working out for me. So my bag collection, as you can see, has really evolved. If you haven't already checked out my bag collection video, I'll leave a link to that video on screen. I hope you found this video helpful, especially if you are considering any of the bags that I've mentioned in this long list of the bags that I sold. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. As always, thank you so much for watching and spending some of your precious time with me today. And I can't wait to see you again soon in my next video. Bye guys.